yeah, it runs on these laptops he's throwing together.
So, another so one. you have loaded onto the laptop itself rather than...
Well, now we're using the internet. Three-dimensional. Not fair. Alright, so yeah, that's
lovely, isn't it?
Yep, that would have helped.
The good thing about it is also that it's open source, so if somebody comes up with something new, you don't have to wait for some huge Britannic encyclopedia to accept the review.
Third derivatives?
Third derivatives?
You don't know?
What is a third derivative?
Okay, in English, the British call it jolt, but the American call it jerk.
Ah,
so
okay.
I have
to work with
third derivatives.
Okay.
Just throw it. Yeah, an event number on the side, which in previous...
contains, like, different combinations. This
electrons start as an electron.
I have some general idea of what you're doing.
It's only a test, right?
You know, you could, if you wanted to, you could put it into the side view and then look at it.
Seven.
Okay, students discover dark matter at William Floyd High School.
11 electrons. Maybe they see a couple of different lines and say, that's close enough, that's an electron. And they're going to read a different number. What happened was an electron and a positron came together. So you're doing exactly what they did, and it's really data from the same experiment.